Hello viewers and my students, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss
30 important MCQs from Shelley's famous poem Towards Skylark. This is set 3. Actually, this set is a continuation of previous two sets. So let's get started. Number 61. In the previous two sets, up to 60 MCQs are completed. So it starts from 61. We feel that it is there. Here, it refers to. The complete line is, until we hardly see, we feel that it is there. So here it refers to the options are bird, moon, firefly, sun. Actually, it refers to the moon because this line is a part of stanza 5. In stanza 5, it is said about the moon. Until we hardly see, we feel that it is there. That is, the moon is invisible in the early morning. Likewise, the skylark or the bird remains invisible, but its song is audible. So here it refers to the moon, obviously. Next, 62. The defense of poetry is a or an. The options are lyric, essay, ode, longer poem. We know that the defense of poetry is actually an essay. So the right option is B, essay. And it was published in 1840. 1840 it was published. Although it was written in 1821, but the essay was published after his death. Next, 63. As from thy presence showers a rain of dash, fill in the blank. The options are light, rays, melody, joy. The full line is, as from thy presence showers a rain of melody. So the right option is C, melody. Then 64, which overflows her bower. And the full line is, with music sweet as love, which overflows her bower. Here her refers to, the options are skylark, rose, moon, highborn maiden. It is obviously the highborn maiden, because the highborn maiden is kept in a palace tower, and there she soothes her lovesick heart with music. With music sweet as love, because music substitutes love, and the lovesick heart is comforted with music. So here her refers to obviously highborn maiden. Next, 65. From rainbow clouds there flow not drops so dash to sea. Fill in the blank. The options are sweet, charming, fierce, bright. Actually, these two lines are from stanza 7. And the lines are, what thou art, we know not. What is most like thee? From rainbow clouds there flow not drops so bright to see. So the right option is D, bright. Next, 66. Towards Skylark was published in. The options are 1818, 1819, 1820, 1822. We know that Towards Skylark was published in the Prometheus Unbound volume in 1820, and in this volume another famous ode, that is Ode to the West Wind, was also published. So the poem was published in 1820 in Prometheus Unbound volume. Next, 67. Whose intense lamp narrows. The full line is, whose intense lamp narrows. Next line, in the white dawn clear, until we hardly see, we feel that it is there. So these are the lines. The lamp narrows in or at the. Actually, here it refers to the moon in the early morning. And in the early morning, the moon remains invisible. So the lamp narrows, or the intense light of the silver spear or moon, or it may also be Venus, gets weaker in the early morning. So the right option is B, early morning. Next, 68. The concept of the skylark is, the options are concrete, inferior, abstract, related to life. Concrete, no. Inferior, no. Skylark is obviously much superior, but this is not the actual option. Abstract, related to life. No, not related to life, because the skylark is the inhabitant of the sky. So the right option is C, abstract. Why abstract? Because Shelley's concept of the bird is something abstract, because such a bird can't exist in reality. It is an ideal one. This is a creation of imagination, Shelley's unattainable ideal. Next, 69. Like an unbodied joy. The full line is, like an unbodied joy whose race is just begun. This is the full line. Here the poet stresses mortality, immortality, superiority, wisdom. Unbodied joy equal to, unbodied equal to without body or bodiless, that is not made of blood and flesh. Not made of blood and flesh equal to spirit. Spirit equal to immortal. So here the poet stresses obviously immortality. The right option is B, because according to Shelley, the bird is immortal, and he repeatedly addresses the bird as blithe spirit, unbodied joy, etc., etc. Next, question number 70. Soothing her love-laden soul in secret hour. She soothes her love-laden soul with. The options are poetry, music, landscape, sweet smell. Actually, these two lines are from stanza 9. And the next lines are, soothing her love-laden soul in secret hour with music sweet as love, which overflows her bower. So, she soothes her love-laden soul with music. Obviously, it is about the highborn maiden who is kept in a palace tower. And there, in her lovesick state, the highborn maiden soothes her love-laden soul with music. Why music? Because music is as sweet as love, or music substitutes love. So the right option is B, music. Next, 71. Shelley died in. We know the lifespan of Shelley. He was born in 1792 and died in an early age of 30 in 1822. So the lifespan is from 1792 to 1822. So the right option is B, 1822. Shelley died in 1822. Next, 72. Like a rose embowered. The rose is here impliedly compared to a or the. The options are lady, male person, moon, earth. Actually, this is a part of stanza 11. And here we find, like a rose embowered in his own green leaves. And here, the rose is impliedly compared to a lady. So, the right option is A, a lady. Next, 73. To a skylark is noted for. The options are allusions, that is indirect reference, realism, then imagery, then pun. The right option is obviously C, imagery, because the poem is noted for imagery, and we find a series of images, and the poet Shelley uses a series of images in order to describe the bird or the song of the bird, and he means to say that the bird is invisible but its song is audible, and in order to explore this idea he resort a series of images. Next, 74. Praise of love means songs in honor of. The options are Bacchus. Bacchus we know, god of wine, so this is not the right option. Triton, sea god, so this is not also the right option. Zeus, supreme god, not the right option. And Venus, goddess of love. So praise of love, this is the option. So the right option is D, Venus. Venus is the goddess of love. Next, 75. What objects are the fountains? Dot dot dot. Here fountains mean the options are waterfalls, brooks, regions, sources. Actually, this line is from stanza 15. Other lines are what objects are the fountains of the happy strain? What fields or waves or mountains, etc. And here fountains means obviously sources. So the right option is D, sources. Next, question number 76. The last line of each stanza of To a Skylark is written in. The options are trochaic pentameter, iambic tetrameter, iambic pentameter, alexandrine. We know there are total 21 stanzas in To a Skylark, and each stanza contains 5 lines, and the first 4 lines are in trimeter, and the last line is written in iambic hexameter or alexandrine. So the right option is D. Now let's explain iambic hexameter or alexandrine. So this is a stanza from To a Skylark. Let's explain iambic hexameter, and we know that the last line is written in iambic hexameter or alexandrine, and here the last line is with music sweet as love which overflows her bower. So we should explain this line, and how it is iambic hexameter we would explain it now. Let's see. At first we have to find out the syllables, and how many syllables are there in this line. Let's see. With music sweet as love which overflows our bower. Let's see. With, then music, it's disyllabic word, so music, two syllables, then sweet, monosyllabic word, then as, monosyllabic word, then love, monosyllabic word, then which, monosyllabic word, then overflows, trisyllabic word, over, then flows. So overflows consists of 3 syllables, overflows, then her, monosyllabic, then bawa, it's also monosyllabic word, like flower, tower, bower, monosyllabic. So in the last line we find total 12 syllables with music, 2 syllables, then sweet as love which overflows, 3 syllables, har bawa. So total in this line we find 12 syllables, and next act is to put accent, and we have to put accent or stress, that is we have to distinguish the accented syllables in this line. Let's see. With music, music, and the first syllable is accented, then sweet, then love, then overflows, over, unaccented, flows, accented, then her, then bawa. And this sign, it is called accent or stress. It is called accent or stress. And this accent or stress falls on or upon vowel. So here mu upon u, then sweet upon e, then love upon o, then over upon o, then flows upon o, then bawa upon o. So this syllable is accented and this syllable is unaccented, and for unaccented syllables no sign is required. And now we have to distinguish these two syllables, and here we find 12 syllables, and if the syllables are divided by 2, so we should take 2 syllables in each foot. And this sign, this is called vertical line, and within this vertical line, these 2 syllables, this is foot, and the singular is foot and the plural is feet, and herein we find total 6 feet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 feet. And when a line consists of 1 foot, it is called monometer. Let's see the list. When a line consists of 1 foot, it is called monometer. When a line consists of 2 feet, so plural is feet, it is called diameter. When a line consists of 3 feet, it is called trimeter. When a line consists of 4 feet, it is called tetrameter. When a line consists of 5 feet, it is called pentameter. And when a line consists of 6 feet, it is called hexameter. So we find monometer, diameter, trimeter, tetrameter, pentameter, hexameter. 1 equal to mono, 2 di, 3 tri, 4 tetra, 5 penta, 6 hexa. And we find here total 6 feet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this line is hexameter. Now let's iambic unaccent accent. Unaccent accent. Each foot we find unaccent accent, and this is called iambus. From iambus, iambus is the noun form and iambic is the adjective form. So together iambus and hexameter equal to iambic hexameter or Alexandrine. So this is Alexandrine. Iambic hexameter. From iambus, iambic, and 6 feet equal to hexameter. So this is iambic hexameter or Alexandrine. So the right option is D, Alexandrine or iambic hexameter. Next, 77. A flood of rapture so divine. This describes the songs of. The options are Venus, Bacchus, the bird, Highborn Maiden. Actually, this line is from stanza 13, and the full line is praise of love or wine that painted forth a flood of rapture so divine. So this describes the song of, obviously, the bird, because the song of the bird is much divine than that of love song and song in honor of Bacchus. Next, 78. By warm winds deflowered. Here the word warm symbolizes. The options are passion, sun rays, vacuity, pessimism. Actually, this is from stanza 11, and here the rose is impliedly compared to a lady and the warm wind is compared to a male lover. So here the word warm means obviously passionate. So the right option is A, passion. Next, 79. Over which clouds are brightening. Here the poet speaks of the rays of the. Actually, this is from stanza 3. The lines are in the golden lightning of the sunken sun over which clouds are brightening. So here the right option is the sun, because here Shelley speaks of the golden lightning of the sun. Next, question number 80. What is the silver spear or star of heaven? The options are planet Jupiter, planet Saturn, planet Venus, planet Mars. And this question was selected in WBSLST 11-12 level in 2016. And the right option is obviously planet Venus, because silver spear or star of heaven means the moon or planet Venus. Next, question number 81. The rhyme scheme of each stanza of To a Skylark is. The options are ABABA, ABABC, ABCAB, ABABB. We know that each stanza of To a Skylark has the rhyme scheme of ABABB. So the right option is D, ABABB. Now let's explain the rhyme scheme. This is a stanza from To a Skylark. Let's explain. Like a highborn maiden. The last word is maiden. We should take the last syllable. It is den. The sound or syllable den, it is A. Next syllable in the second line, in a palace tower. The last syllable is tower. So den tower. Tower, the sound is different. So it's B. Next, soothing her love laden. The last syllable is den. So, maiden laden, den, den. Same sound, so it's also a. Then, our, tower, our. Same sound, so it's also b. And then, last line, with music sweet as love whose overflows are bower. The last syllable is bower. So, tower, our, bower. Same sound, so it's also b. So, the rhyme scheme of this stanza is AB, AB, B. So, this is the rhyme scheme. And every stanza contains this rhyme scheme. AB, AB, B. That is, the first line rhymes with the third and the second line rhymes with the fourth and fifth. So, the rhyme scheme is AB, AB, B. So, this is the rhyme scheme. The right option is AB, AB, B. Next, 82. Thou of death must deem things more true and deep. Here the bird resembles. Here, Shelley compares the bird to a philosopher. Like a philosopher, the bird possesses a deeper and truer knowledge about death. So, the right option is C, philosopher. Next, 83. Whose race is just begun? The race begins in or at. The options are the early morning, night, the evening, noon. And we know that Skylark starts his journey in the early morning. So the right option is the early morning, A. Then, 84. Waking or asleep. This expression means the options are daytime, life and death, always, night only. Actually, waking or asleep means always, all the times. The right option is C. Next, 85. Chorus hymeneal means the options are a dirge, a choric song, a lullaby, a marriage song. This question was selected in WBSLST 2016 in the 9-10 level. Let's see the options again. A dirge means funeral song. A choric song equal to song of the chorus. A lullaby means song sung to send a child to sleep. So this is also not the right option. And D, a marriage hymn or marriage song. And we know that chorus hymeneal comes from the word hymen. And Hymen is the god of marriage according to Greek mythology. So the right option is D, a marriage hymn. Next, 86. Keen as are the arrows of that silver spear. This is an example of climax, simile, interrogation, pun. And here we know as, that is the rays are compared to that of the arrows. An explicit comparison we find here. And the comparison is explicit due to the use of the word as. So the right option is B, simile. Next, 87. Things more true and dot 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 fill in the blank. Let's see the options. A, real. B, latent. C, deep. D, bare. Actually, this line is from stanza 17. Waking or asleep, thou of death must deem things more true and deep. So the right option is C, deep. So 87, C, deep. Next, 88. The Necessity of Atheism was published in. The options are 1809, 1810, 1811, 1812. We know that Shelley was expelled from Oxford in 1811 because he published a pamphlet called The Necessity of Atheism. So the right option is C, 1811. Next, 89. Thou of death must dim. Here, dim means fear, sweet, sing, consider. We know the lines in stanza 17. Thou of death must dim things more true and deep. So here, dim means obviously consider. Know, consider, knowledge. So the right option is D. Then last one, 90. Yet if we could scorn, here scorn means the options are avoid, pride, fear, think. Actually, this is from stanza 19. The lines are, yet if we could scorn hate and pride and fear, if we were things born not to shed our tear, dot, 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 dot. So, here scorn means, obviously, avoid. The right option is A. Completed all the questions.